Hi, I am Ms. Raz, SAP Basis Trainer. In this video, I am going to explain what is instance profile and how to use it to change different types of parameters within the SAP system. As we have seen in earlier videos, how to use default profile, in the same way we can also look at the instance profile file at operating system level in USR folder SAP. So here we have two systems, that is development and quality. So just double click on development, one of the system, and inside dev there is a sys folder. Double click on it and then profile folder. So here these are all called different types of profile files. Out of these profile files, instance specific profile, so this is central instance specific file, and this is dialog instance specific file, this is dialog instance specific file. So just we'll use this particular profile file to change some parameter within the SAP system. So let us look at how to change some parameter within SAP system. Just remember the name of this particular instance. This name starts with the SID, system identifier, that is dev, dev underscore DVEBMGS00 underscore NW7EHP1. NW7EHP1 is nothing but the host name of this particular server. Okay, let us log on to SAP system using SAP logon program from the desktop. Double click on it. So here you can see four types of entries. Out of these four types of entries, first one is belongs to central instance of the development system. The central instance of the development system means in the SAP MMC. MMC means that is Microsoft Management Console, SAP Management Console. The instance is already started. Just let me show you quickly. Here, this is the central instance. This one is the central instance, NW7EHP1. So this file belongs to this instance, and this file belongs to this instance, and next this file belongs to this instance. That means each and every instance has its own profile, that is instance profile file, in operating system level as well as at SAP system level. So we have seen that instance profile file of operating system level. Let us look at SAP system level. To look at SAP system level, just double click on this entry. This entry belongs to central instance of the SAP system, that is 00, here 00. That is 0 means single 0 denotes 00 here. That is called instance number. So this is instance number is 00 and the system identifier is DEV. Just click OK. Just entry, I have shown you the properties. Just while creating this entry, you have to use those values to create the entry. Just double click on it. And this is the SAP initial screen. From here, we can enter into the system using any of the client available. So now I am using 001 client to log into. And to look at, that is to edit the profile, you have to use RZ10T code. So here the profile field contains blank, that means nothing, no profile is entered here. So if you want to edit the profile, you have to enter that particular file here. So how you can enter that particular file? Using this possible options button or F4 from your keyboard. Just click on it so that the system will show all the profile files available within the system. That is default development, that is development dialog instance 1, development dialog instance 2, that is instance profile, and development central instance, that is also instance profile, and 3 more profile files are available. In next video I will cover what is this start profile. Okay, for timing, within this video just look at this particular file. I am selecting that file and click on copy, so that the file will be displayed within this field, within this profile field. And the version of this particular profile file is 4, number 4. That means each and every time you make some changes to this particular instance specific profile, the version will be incremented by 1. So now I am going to do some change in the parameters available for this particular instance. The number will be incremented to 5. Just observe that. Okay, so to change the parameter, first of all you have to select either of these 3 options, that is administrative data, basic maintenance, or extended maintenance. Administrative data shows little bit information about this particular profile file, and basic maintenance some more information will be shown. Extended maintenance, everything will be shown in the technical terms, that is technical names of the parameters, different parameters are available for this particular instance, it will show. Okay, so let us use first administrative data to look at what it contains. Just click on the display or change button. If you want to look at the information, you can use the display button. If you want to change something within this, you can use the change button from here. Just I am clicking on the display button. Once you click on the display button, you will see what is the information, that is administrative data. That means the type of profile, profile type is instance profile, and the name of the server is this, that is NW7HP1_dev_00, and the activation in operating system file, the location of the file, it is showing like this, that is NW7EHP1, that is network path. SAP MNT is nothing but C:\USR SAP and dev sys profile, where we have browsed this same profile, same path it is showing, and but it is network path. Okay, just once you look at this information, you can click on the back button to go to previous screen. Just click on back or F3 key from your keyboard. So again, you will come to edit profile screen, and here you can click on basic maintenance to look at the information. Click on display. So this is the basic information about the instance profile. This instance has this many work processes, that is network, number of work processes, that is dialog 12, update 1, update 2, 1, NQ1, background 3, spool 1, and different buffer sizes also it will show, that is ABAP programs, that is 300 MB it is showing, and name tab, generic key tables, single key tables, UA information, screens, and this type of parameters, that is memory parameters and number of work processes are displayed in this basic maintenance screen. And you can click on go back to the go to previous screen. Just select the extended maintenance and click on display, so that you can view all the parameters, that is technical names will be displayed of all the parameters. And if you want to change something from here, you can also use the change button from here, that is display change switch button it is, or you can go back and click on the change button. Okay, here the rdisp/wp_no, that is number_dia means dialog work processes, that is number of dialog work processes within this instance are 12. If you want to increase or decrease this number, you can double click on this particular parameter, double click on this particular parameter to change it. Just I am doing that, double click on this particular parameter, double click it. Now the number is showing as 12. Just like, let us look at this number of work processes using SM50T code by opening another session. This button used for opening another session. Just click on it, and from here you can execute the T code SM50. SM50 is for looking at work process or you. Look at here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 dialogue work processes are available. So I am going to make these 12 dialogue work processes to 14. That means I am going to increase that particular number by 2. So how to increase? Just open the previous session. Here instead of 12, I can make it 14. So once I change it to 14, just click on copy and changes were made within the screen. Just go back using back button or F3 from the keyboard, and again the main screen of the profile maintenance, that is instance profile maintenance, just click on copy again. Just see the parameter changed to 14. Again click on the copy button to the changed profile was transferred. Okay, it will transfer to the database as well as to the operating system level file. Okay, so once it is done, again click on copy and click on go back button. From here you can click on the save button. Once I click on the save button, and after completion of this, this version will be changed to 5, that will be incremented by 1. Click on save. And do you want to activate the profile? Yes, I want to activate the profile. Just click yes. And profile dev_dvebmgs00_nw7ehp1 version 00005 saved and activated. That means this particular profile file is saved and also it is activated. Okay, so once it is activated, just click on continue. Okay, click on continue, and this information, just read it out. That is caution, caution, caution. The effect of activating a profile is simply that the profile is stored at operating system level. It is simply stored at operating system level. For the profile to take effect for a particular application server, you have to restart the application server. Why? Because when the instance is started, then only the profile will be read by the instance. So when you restart it, this particular change will come into effect. Okay, that is the meaning of this message. Just continue from here. Okay, the version changed to 5. Okay, click on system and click on log off. Click on yes. Okay, we have come out from the system. Now we have to restart the instance. Right click on that particular instance and click on restart, so that the instance will be restarted. First of all, it will stop, and then after that it will be started. Just click on refresh button. You can see the status of the shutting down. Keep on refreshing so that you will see the down. Status is down now. Keep on refreshing. Yes, completely gone. And if you click on process list, and the services are going to stop. Everything became the gray color. Gray color means it is completely stopped. If you want to start it again, or it is automatically starting because we have clicked on the restart. Okay, just wait for some time so that it will be started. Yes, you see it is starting. It's starting. And here also you keep on refreshing, and status is getting to wait, and the start is getting to yes. It's completely wait and yes. That means it is completely started, and the color also changed to green color. Okay, second time it will started very fast. First time if you start it, it will take some time to start everything. It is now completely green color. We can start logging into system. Just double click on dev. Now we can check number of work processes within the system. SM50 is the T code for looking at number of dialogue work processes. You see how many dialogue work processes are there now. You can count it. From here 0 to 13. That means 14 dialogue work processes are available right now within this particular application server, or also it is called as instance, that is central instance. Okay, and you can also look at this information at the operating system level. Just here from the SAP management console, if you look at number of work processes, See, 0 to 13, all are type, DIA means dialog work processes. And profile level, if you look inside the file, just right click and click on open, click on notepad, click OK, so that it will show all the details, what are all the changes we have done. Okay, see how many changes done by me, that is DDIC user changed these things. And just now we have changed one thing, you know, that is rdisp/wp_no_dia=14. Who have changed? Changed by SAP user 18/12/2013, that is 22-37 time. Okay, so in this way the information will be maintained at operating system level, because each time you starting a instance means it will refer this particular file to start. This particular instance profile file will be used for starting an instance. So in this way you can recognize the instance profile at operating system level and at SAP system level, and it can be used in this way to change some of the parameters. Okay, you can change any type of parameters in the same procedure. I hope you understood very well. Okay, thanks for watching.